Today I'm going to try to update the firmware on my modded Switch by following Aesthetics' tutorial. I'll show you how easy it is. As you can see, this is the version of Hecate I'm currently running. And here are the versions of the firmware and atmosphere that I have on my Switch right now. Alright, let's start the update. Before updating the firmware on a modded Switch, we'll need to update Hecate and atmosphere. Thankfully, Aesthetics' Hats Pack already includes the latest versions of Hecate and Atmosphere, so we can just download that. To do so, go to Aesthetics' website and find the releases page for the Hats Pack. I'll put the link down in the description. You can see on this page all the things included in the Hats Pack. Scroll down till you see the download button and click it. Next, we'll need to get the firmware. To do so, go to Darth Sterney's firmware archive, which I will link in the description. I'll be updating my Switch to firmware 19.0 today, but if you're watching this in the future, grab the latest firmware supported by the Hats Pack that you downloaded. After downloading the Hats Pack and firmware on your PC, turn off your Switch completely, remove the SD card from the Switch and plug it into the PC. According to Aesthetics' tutorial, the easiest way to install the Hats Pack is to remove the Atmosphere, Bootloader, and Config folders. If you want to be safe, you can make a backup of those folders before deleting them. Once you delete those folders, find the Hats Pack and unzip it. Then, copy and paste the contents onto the SD card. Next, create a folder on the root of your SD card. I usually write the firmware version as the name of this folder. Then, find the firmware you downloaded and unzip it. Copy and paste everything to the folder that we created on the SD card. Now that's done, we'll put the SD card back in the Switch and turn it on. You should boot up into Hecate, and it will ask you to input the current date and time. As you can see, Hecate has been updated to the latest version. Now, we'll need to first install the firmware on the SysMMC. So tap Launch and then tap SysMMC. Open the Homebrew menu by going to the album. Then, open the Daybreak application. Click Install, then click the folder that you saved the firmware update to. Click Continue. Preserve Settings. Install FAT32 and XFAT. And then Continue. When Daybreak is done installing the firmware update, press reboot. Your system should now load back into Hecate. I'm going to launch into the SysMMC again to show you that the latest firmware and atmosphere are now installed on the SysMMC. As you can see, atmosphere and the firmware have been updated to the latest versions. Next, we'll have to update the EMU-MMC, which is completely separate from the SysMMC. The EMU-MMC is usually where you have all your game backups and homebrew and anything else you don't want Nintendo to know about. To do so, reboot the Switch and head back into Hecate again. This time, boot into the EMU-MMC. And again, go to the Homebrew menu, find Daybreak, and repeat the steps we did before to install the firmware. Once Daybreak finishes installing the firmware update for the EMU MMC, press reboot. Your system should now load back into Hecate. I'm going to boot into the EMU MMC again to show that it's updated. As you can see, the firmware and atmosphere have been updated. And that's it. Pretty easy, right? You should now be able to install the latest games and updates on your modded Switch. Hope this video shows you how easy it is to update the firmware. If an average Joe like me can get it done, then you can do it too. Huge thanks to Aesthetics for the tutorial and for maintaining the hats pack. You can check out his channel using the links below. Like the video? Don't forget to subscribe.